Yeah.
No, it ain't
that
far.
Okay, okay.
Yeah.
Y'all tour?
Yeah.
Okay, so I don't know.
No, you good. I say, I hit you up, you know what I'm saying?
Jeremiah 29, 50 and 50. Okay. 50 and 29.
Yeah, Saturday. Yeah, Saturday night.
You know what I'm saying? I don't
think that far. I got it. I'm going to do some Bible, baptism.
Jeremiah 51:3. Against him that bendeth the bow, bendeth, let the archer bend his bow, and against him that lifted himself up in his brigandine, and spare ye not her young men, destroy ye utterly all her hosts.
Yeah, destroy ye utterly all her hosts, meaning there's going to be no survivors. You know what I'm saying? The only one that's going to survive the nuclear missiles is the elect, man.
Yeah, utterly miss completely.
Done, yeah.
For Israel hath not been forsaken, nor Judah of his power, of the Lord of hosts, though their land was filled with sin against the Holy One of Israel.
And that's why we are in the condition that we in right now, is for the fact that we went off and served other gods, man. Made sacrifice to other gods. Followed after other nations' customs, man. All right, but even at the end of the day, the Lord is still rocking with the elect, man. That's why you have two-thirds. Can you grab that right quick? Zechariah?
Yeah.
That's why you have two-thirds, man. That's the purpose of the two-thirds, is for them to continue in the wickedness. And they like a sacrifice for the elect, man. Because they're going to continue in their wickedness, continue following after America and thinking that this place is right, or that they only got one life to live. You know what I'm saying? Once you die, you get your judgment for your next life. You know? That's that, being that this is the last punishment.
Correct that too. Rock up. You know, just clear it up. That the elect, I mean, the two-thirds, they're like, you know, they're getting their judgment, man. You know what I'm saying? Because they're not even worthy of being a sacrifice. You know, only the main worthy thing that's worthy, because when you make a sacrifice for the Most High, it's something that's special. You know, a lamb, a firstborn lamb, unspotted. You know, turtle dove. These two-thirds ain't shit, man. They're just burning garbage. That's all the Most High is doing, is burning garbage, man. You know, Yahweh Shai is ultimately, that's a sacrifice, man. Them niggas is a waste of skin, man. You know, they gotta get destroyed so they can come back in the right mind. The Most High is just helping them get into the kingdom, man. Really. Because you ain't, like the brother said, they ain't gonna come the right avenue. They ain't gonna get right, you know.
Zechariah chapter 13, verse 8. And it shall come to pass that in all the land, saith the Lord, two parts therein shall be cut off and die.
Yeah, that's two parts. It's the two-thirds that we speak of, man, of our nation. Sitting right here in America, they're going to be destroyed. All right? Because like we just said, they don't want to get right. Not only are they wrong, but they don't want to get right, man. They really sit here in America and it's comfortable being on the bottom, man. I was just in the car and it hit me like, man, the Lord has to come back, man. You know what I'm saying? But you have people in our nation that's comfortable with being on the bottom. Why would you be comfortable with being on the bottom when you are a king, man? You are one of the special people on this earth.
Talking about things could be worse.
What's worse?
Things could be better.
Yeah.
You know?
Things could be at its best, man. Your own kingdom. You really sit here and justify the wickedness of the so-called white man just to look forward to a 2016 Tahoe. Just to look forward to being in a higher tax bracket. Or just to look forward to being set at liberty, man. At liberty from the Most High's law. All of that is really more important than salvation, man. Even fighting for salvation. Like, if I didn't have this truth, I don't know what I would be doing. It'd be wickedness, most likely, because I don't have the truth. But it's just so much evil and wickedness out here, so easy to get into, man. Why would you even think this is life? You think life is that easy for you? You can do whatever you want and still get saved?
Like I said, when there's no law, there's no sin. You know, if the law's not existing, you won't know what to do. You know, you'll just do what you want. You know, and you wouldn't think nothing's wrong with that. You know?
And the so-called white man, he has put the perfect fantasy in front of your face, man. For you to be, actually be comfortable in America and think that this is it. And think that the one who the world called Jesus Christ is white. You even comfortable with that? You got niggas talking about, what does it matter, the color? Nigga, because it matters. Because the Bible say different and the depiction that they put up ain't what the Bible say. That's why it matters.
Like I said last week, it's for truth's sake. Why do you go to the Bible? You don't go to the Bible because the quotes are good. You go to the quotes of real life. They hit home. When you read Proverbs, y'all like to read Psalms, it's things that you're actually going through. It speaks to you in reality. So why would you pick up a book and deal with it based off of its reality and create a bunch of imaginary stories and tales, man? That's oxymoron, man. To sit there and say, yeah, basically I pick up the Bible because it keep it real with me. And then be like, oh, well, Jesus is white. Or Yahweh Shai is white. You know? That's an oxymoron, man. And then say, what does it matter? Because it's true. Don't you read Proverbs? You don't read Proverbs and say, oh, man, that's a funny scripture. You know, it's not, or it's a lie, or you don't read it. Science fiction book, man. You read it because of its clarity and reality, man. So why say Yahweh Shai is white? Why say Noah was white? You know, why say the Lord dealing with everybody? If you're picking up this book based off of truth's sake, man. You know why? Because Esau, once again, does not want, and Jake picked up the habit too. They don't want to own up to their responsibility. They don't want to own up to their sin, man. They won't own up to their current situation. They don't want to repent. They don't want to change, man. You know? They want to have the Lord and be a nigga at the same time. Or Esau want to be saved and not say sorry. When I say sorry, it's showing that you're sorry and actually repenting. They don't want to do that deep down, you know? Even if you could, you couldn't. But Esau, the bulk of them Edomites don't want to repent, man. Okay? They're not going to sacrifice their life. Because really, the only way you can repay somebody by taking their life is by giving yours. You know? They're not going to get down at the bottom. They'll sit there and say, oh, I'm sorry, and go back to their mansion. Or go back to their live good lifestyle. You know? Sorry ain't going to cut it. You know? The scriptures say, the land was polluted by blood, and the only way you cleanse it is by blood. So it's tit for tat, man. It's balance, man. You steal, you gotta give back what you stole, and you gotta give double, man. That means you gotta kill you and your whole family. You know? That's why Esau's judgment is double, man. But they don't want to give that up, though. You know, why not? You know, why would you want to give up your kingdom? Why? You know? That's why we just tell y'all to live it up in y'all kingdom. Have fun. So-called white people go around, y'all committing all these atrocities, Monsanto, GMOs, polluting the water, the air, and then want God to forgive you. No. Go live it up. Go be a demon and just accept your fate. You know? Don't try to come and get the grace of the Most High and at the same time destroy the world, man. You know? That's why the Lord said, what? You're not of the world. Because I chose you out of the world. When we was closed-minded, we was doing all kind of niggerish shit, man. But when the Lord woke us up, we began to what? We repented and we did right, man.
and we try to fix all our, we try to right all our wrongs, man. And we know that, you know, we can't right our wrongs. It's the grace of the Most High if he's going to accept us or not. But not, not the so-called white man. He believes he could be saved no matter what he does. All you got to do is call upon the name of Jesus. It don't work like that, man. You know, the atrocities that the so-called white man's committed, nothing is acceptable for him but death. And it, him as a whole nation, man, wiped out, man. And that's gonna bring, that's what that's gonna bring, peace to the world.